Hello, Facebook. Today we're talking about healing. Healing is the dinner bell. It rings and salvation follows. I love that. I have seen this happen in my life because it happens in the Word. I mean, that's what the Word says. Let's look at 1 Kings 17. Elijah was living with a widow and her son became very sick. When this happened, she went to Elijah. In 1 Kings 17:18, so she said to Elijah, "What have I to do with you, O man of God? Have you come to bring my sin to remembrance and to kill my son?" She was very distressed and afraid her son was going to die. But Elijah responded in faith. He took the boy up to his room and began to pray for him. 1 Kings 17:20-22. Then he cried out to the Lord and said, "O Lord, my God, have you also brought tragedy on the widow with whom I lodge by killing her son?" And he stretched himself out on this child three times and cried out to the Lord and said, "O Lord, my God, I pray you, let this child's soul come back to him." Then the Lord heard the voice of Elijah, and the soul of the child came back to him, and he revived. We know that healing is the bread of the children. Matthew 15:26-28, Jesus answered and said, "It is not good to take the children's bread and throw it to the little dogs." And I love the way she responded. "Yes, Lord, even the little dogs eat the crumbs which fall from their master's table." I tell you, he said, "Oh, woman, great is your faith. Let it be to you as you desire." And her daughter was healed from that very hour. When we ask the Lord for healing, he is faithful to heal. If you need healing in your body, or you know someone who does, please go to our website. Leave a prayer request. We want for you to be healed today. We do. 1 Peter 2:24. "He himself bore our sins in his own body on the tree, that we, having died to sins, might live for righteousness, by whose stripes you were healed." God reveals himself through healing. In the Bible's account of Elijah and the widow, her son is healed. Ooh, is that wonderful? It is. After the widow sees his healing, she sees that Elijah is a man of God. Then the woman said to Elijah, "Now by this I know that you are a man of God, and that the word of the Lord in your mouth is truth." Before that time, she used to worship Baal, but through this miracle, she came to know that God is real and spoke through Elijah. We also see God using healing in the story of Naaman in 2 Kings 5. After he gets healed, Naaman realized the truth of who God is. And in 2 Kings 15, Naaman said, "Indeed, now I know there is no God in all the earth except in Israel." Healing rings the dinner bell for salvation. Let me tell how this works in international ministry. Especially, I've seen it in Pakistan. When people receive healing, God reveals himself, especially if someone is not saved. Receiving the gift of healing leads to salvation. I want to pray for you right now. Number one, I want to pray for people who need healing. So, Father, I pray for whoever is watching this who needs to be healed, to bring healing. I pray for healing for unsaved loved ones. God, this is important to us. I pray for restoration of relationships. I pray for financial provision for those who need miracles in their finances. So, Father, we pray for unsaved loved ones. We pray for restoration of relationships. We pray for financial provision for those who need healing in their finances. And we just pray for those who need healing, period. That's important. And I want to thank you for watching today. Remember, healing is the dinner bell, and God wants to heal you today.